tent.
Okay.
And the chairs with the ribbons on it is where you guys will sit.
Okay.
Okay? And then when we get in here, we'll get it, get you out of the sun.
Okay, so
tell them where they're stopping?
I didn't tell them.
Alright, they need to know where they're stopping.
Just before that, those cones.
Yeah, pretty much. Like
just a little bit before those cones is where you're stopping, right?
Yeah. That big tree? Right,
yeah. That's a good one. Once you drive, stop. That your signal is or whatever, would have to stop a couple seconds, whatever. Face each other, and you guys can turn around and just march. So let's go ahead and move this
Thank you.
just saw was the procession of our rodeo king and queen horse for 2012. Before we introduce you to our chairwoman of the board of directors for the Ebony Horsewomen for the official welcome, I'd like to take an opportunity to welcome our visiting queen. These visions, which we're standing. First, we have Abigail Velez, Miss Puerto Rico of Hartford, 2012.
Century when we were moving west. They're not written much in the history, but they did great things. They were cowgirls and cowboys that led our country into the future. And here in Hartford, in a small way, you're very much tied to that same history because you're leading the way as young men and women to be the bright future that you all have the ability to attain. And first, I'd want to say congratulations to all of you for the good work that you're doing. Far too often in our community, it's the bad things that are highlighted. But this year, this is good. This is what community is all about. And I just, on behalf of the city of Hartford, want to say thank you to you all, congratulations, and all the best in your future endeavors. Keep up the good work.
I'm very pleased to be here, and I won't be long, but I did want to tell you, I'm standing here, and as you were walking in, I was so impressed with your poise, with your demeanor. You are beautiful people who I know perform beautifully in your various interviews and in settings. And I suspect that what you have just been through has been an extraordinarily memorable leadership development experience. I am in the business of being able to recognize leaders when I see them. In fact, just last fall, we were able to recognize Pat Kelly as one of the most outstanding leaders in our community. She was given a Polaris Award. The highest award we give to leaders in this community for the inspiration, the guidance she has given so many of us. This institution is not well known enough. We enjoy introducing it to people. We enjoy making this known to folks. But we have, all of us need to be committed to making sure Ebony Horsewomen is known to the whole world, because this is a place that absolutely requires our full support. It is worthy of our support so that it can continue to produce the kind of leaders that sit before me at this moment.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Captain Anthony Taylor, the Hartford Fire Department Special Services Unit. As I was standing over there with my wife and enjoying this wonderful event, I was thinking how many times I've driven up and back on Vine Street. And what we need to do is we need to start right here at home and get the residents of the city of Hartford to stop going north and south and start turning right and left into a wonderful place of fun, entertainment, and insight. Because this is a wonderful opportunity for our children to branch off and do something that's a little bit different than the norm. Thank you very much.
Myra, we're gonna come in. We're gonna ask you to come in and have a couple words about the process and how you felt the kids did.
Tell me how it went. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I had the distinct pleasure of being one of the three judges who spent the last 6 to 7 months with the candidates for Rodeo King, Rodeo Queen, Rodeo Prince, and Rodeo Prince. This is not an easy competition, because unlike other pageants, it's really not about beauty in this one. The King, the students, we saw tremendous growth. They are all winners, incredible winners, and we should just give them a round of applause.
Every kid here is basically, they know things, but every kid here is great. So even, it doesn't matter who you're running against, it's gonna be a challenge. But it shouldn't change anything between you and your friends, you know, everything will always be the same, and I just wish you guys the best of luck. Me being Rodeo King really changed my life because, you know, I actually had a lot of responsibility, you know. It wasn't just, you know, come to the barn and everyday thing, like I actually had a title and responsibility. So you have to, there are some things you have to take care of. And you know, just wish you guys good luck. Thank you.
So we would be very, very, very remiss if we didn't have words from our visiting queens, and we'll let them to come up in the order that they choose.
Hi, I'm Katie Briscoe. I'm Miss Caribbean American 2011. I just want to wish you guys all good luck because you're making a positive influence. And I know it can be hard sometimes because you have to get up here, speak in front of people, and you have a title and you have to be responsible, but I just encourage you all to do your best, and I encourage you to shine through and let your light show. So good luck, everyone.
Hi, My name is Abigail Velez. I'm Miss Puerto Rico Harper 2012, and it is a great honor to have the title of Miss Puerto Rico Harper because I love being Puerto Rican, and I just love to be a role model for my peers, and I can't wait to see what's in front of me. Thank you.
Hi, good evening. My name is Ebony Horsewomen. I'm Miss Horsemanship 2011. I just want to wish you guys all luck and encourage you just to be involved in your community and be helpful to the people around you.
We are going to honor one of our own who has given so much to this organization ever since she was a child.
Able to present an exemplary commitment and leadership award to Miss Heather Lawson.
Thank you so much.
You all know my mother, Patricia Kelly, who is the visionary of this organization. And without her, none of us would be here. And it started, you all may know the story by now, it started with us riding horses in the back of a guy's house named Puddinghead, who was one of the original members of the Ebony Horsewomen. And I was there because I was always connected to her like I still am, holding on for dear life, don't go. And we looked at each other and said, this is fun. We should keep doing this. We didn't know how we were going to keep doing it, but we said this is fun. It's better than going to the mall.
What's
the
bar? No bar. 84 no bar.
We should keep doing this. From that moment, my first love was created. The Ebony Horsewomen Incorporated. So while I am deeply honored and humbled by this award, there is really no place else I'd rather be than here with you all. Here making sure that the barn has what it needs, watching all of these young men and women grow up and make me feel old, and being a part of special occasions like this where we're going to have the new crowning of the next guard of the Ebony Horsewomen Incorporated. And so I'm just surprised and I'm honored, and I just want to say thank you very, very much.
This was not an easy process, and we want to, on behalf of Lee, myself, Mr. Lee, myself, and Chelsea, really give a final acknowledgement to the amazing work of all of the candidates in this process.
Yes.
We will start with the Rodeo Queen. We will crown the Rodeo Queen, and then acknowledge the runners-up in their order. So we are going to ask Miss Puerto Rico of Hartford to please step forward, as she will be our honored guest in the crowning. And the envelope says, the 2012 Ebony Horsewomen Rodeo Queen is Miss Angelina Romero.
Congratulations.
The first runner-up of the Rodeo Queen competition is Miss Alana DeCart. We're now going to crown the king. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2012 Ebony Horsewomen's Rodeo King is Mr. Anthony Helis Jr. Unable to be with us this evening. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2012 Ebony Horsewomen Rodeo Prince says is Miss Princess Mason. Thank you very much. It was our pleasure to be a part of this journey.